confession. I believe in the name of Jesus Christ. Hey! I believe in a crucifixion. By his blood I have been set free. I believe in a resurrection. Hallelujah, his life is destined. All praise to God the Father. All praise to Christ the Son. All praise to the Holy Spirit. Our God has overcome. The King who was and is and evermore will be. In Jesus' name. Preparing a place for me, far beyond what hearts imagine, ears have heard or eyes have seen.
Songs that they sang for us in Belize, so we'll hope to do them some justice.
Save us all and all the people. said amen. Whoa, and all the people said amen. Give thanks to the Lord, for his love never ends. And all the people said amen. And all the people said amen. Oh, and all the people said amen. Give thanks to the Lord, for his love never ends. And all the people said amen. Blessed are the poor in spirit who are torn apart. Blessed are the persecuted and the pure in heart. Blessed are the people hungry for another star. For this is the kingdom of God. And all the people said amen. Oh, and all the people said amen. Give thanks to the Lord, for his love never ends. And all the people said amen. And all the people said amen. And all the people said amen. Give thanks to the Lord, for his love never ends. And all the people said amen. And all the people said amen.
Amen.
soon dissolve like snow. The sun forbid to shine, but God, you called me here below, will be forever mine. Will be.
Thank you for showering your love over us over and over again. I thank you for giving us the opportunity to praise and worship you and to speak about our trip and what we were able to do. I thank you and praise you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Good morning. It is great to have you all here today. Thank you so much for coming out. It means a lot to us to see so many friends and family and church family out here willing to come and want to hear a little bit about our trip to Belize that we took a few weeks ago. We are humbled and we are so grateful, not only for your attendance today, but for your support throughout the process of getting this adventure, this trip together, whether it was, you know, helping out at Hillbilly Hike, or whether it was the constant prayers that you had for us throughout the trip, and the words of encouragement that you did throughout. It was all greatly appreciated. Thank you so much for your support. Thank you for being a part of our team, even if you didn't quite get to get on the plane and go. Anytime you take a trip to Belize, or any trip for that matter, it's the word that I always use to describe it is adventure. It's always an adventure, regardless of how, or you kind of know what you're going to do, you kind of know where you're going to go, and where you kind of want to end, but how you get there is always kind of ups and downs, and trusting God through it all. Kind of leading up to it, I mean, we were always kind of thrown for a loop. We were on the Saturday before we were supposed to go, Julie got sick and was unable to go with us, which was pretty crazy because, you know, she's been on every single trip up to that point, you know, with me. So, you know, she was a pivotal role. She plays a pivotal role a lot in the children's ministry and can kind of help be a voice of experience. And so, you know, that kind of threw us for a loop a little bit, but we are glad that she is improving and getting better, but as well as the same time, we definitely missed her on our trip. And then just kind of the travel experience. Any time that you have to travel, I mean, that might be the biggest areas where you have to trust God, like as going through airports, because it's insane. You would think that Des Moines would be pretty easy to get through, but Des Moines was, like, really challenging on that first Sunday morning in which we went to Belize. We were there plenty early, especially, you know, for traveling out and flying out. But I would say we barely made our flight. It was pretty crazy. But we made it, and we got there, and we got home, and so that was a really good thing. But an adventure it was. All of us in 2020 experienced a pandemic, and the pandemic just wasn't for America. It was a global pandemic. And so what was very interesting and fascinating for myself, from my perspective, was seeing the differences in Belize and how things have changed from before the pandemic to now. For example, the kids were out of school in Belize for nearly 2 years. Which, when we did our children's ministry, it led to some challenges because a lot of the younger kids were not, usually they know more of the songs and know more of the Bible than we probably do. And so when we got there, it wasn't necessarily the case. Several of the songs in which we had planned to do, which they had known in the past, they did not quite know as well as we thought they would. And so that was kind of interesting. But I think it's because of, a lot of it was because they haven't done a lot of chapel recently. They haven't been involved in that, and COVID kind of messed them up for not being involved and into a routine for 2 different years. Hearing the stories about the different people and how they dealt with some of their illnesses and some of the vaccine stuff and all of that kind of stuff that they dealt with from their perspective was quite fascinating. I'm going to talk for a few minutes about what we did in Belize. I'm going to kind of hammer out some of the things what we're going to do. And then what's going to happen then is you're going to get hopefully there'll be a Belize person in each table. And what we'll do is they'll have 10 minutes or so, and they can talk to you through some questions. And then about 10 minutes, I'll have everybody flip-flop. Like, I'll have the Belize teams get up and switch tables, and they can do it all again. This gives you an opportunity to hear a voice from somebody else other than myself. The school ministry in which we did, I kind of touched on that about how it was different. One of the ways that we challenged, the team is challenged the most, is because of this. You ask anybody, this is probably one of the hardest things in which they have to do. They have to prepare a devotion. They have to give the devotion in front of people. They have to sing, maybe even have to be goofy in skits. Whatever it is a challenge. I mean, it is probably about an hour or 45 minutes of our day in which we do. But with that said, for some of the people that are involved, it's the most challenging for them because it's the most out of their comfort zone that they have to get. You know, hammering nails or picking up trash or putting boards on. For some of them, that's pretty easy. But getting in front of people and speaking, that was kind of a challenge. And I heard that over and over again from numerous people on our team about how, you know, it was how challenging it was and how fearful they were at the very beginning. But then afterwards, many of them said how rewarding it was and how it was great just to walk into the school and how much they just loved to see us there. Whether we went to 2 different schools, we divided our group in half. We went to one. It's one school, but 2 separate places with older kids and then younger kids at the other school. And so we would walk in, and just the the amount of time that we spent playing with them in the yards and just the first 15 or 20 minutes of the time of walking in and just the excitement and joy that they had that we were there and they had somebody to play with, and it was a little bit different because they don't have a playground. They don't have things that we have at our school. They don't have air conditioning. They don't even have, I don't even know if they have doors on some of their classrooms, you know. And so they don't have a lunchroom. They don't have any of these things that we're used to. And I think it's really relatable for a lot of the kids in our group that went, because that's kind of what they know. They know the school. That's what they've done their whole entire life. They've done school. They've gone to school. They've been at school. And so it's a really good comparison from that for them to see kind of how their schools are compared to how some of the other kids are. What I really loved about our group was that they found different ways in which they could interact with the kids, whether it was racing them. I think Craig lost this race, if I remember correctly. Arm wrestling, or each other in this case. But they found ways in which they could interact with the kids while they were there. What I thought was kind of funny, and I should have put the picture of it up there, but there's a picture of Dan White, and Dan's like, I'm old. I don't know. They probably look at me and think I'm creepy, you know, kind of thing. But you know what Dan did? He used what he had. He went, he got his tape measure out, and he started measuring people. And all of a sudden, I look over, and there's a line of like 20 people waiting to get measured by a tape measure by Dan. But that's the thing. We use what we can have, whether it's paper, rock, scissors, whether it's running, whether it's playing tag, whether it's a tape measure. But ways in which we can build relationships and interact with the students and the kids that are there, it was awesome. So we did some skits, and we did some different things to try to present the gospel to them. We also, after we finished with our kids' ministries during in the early morning, we would go on and we would do our work project. So our first work project was with a lady named Martha. We put half of our group there, and some of the things in which they did at that project was they built some stairs, they helped fix some electrical, they did some framing, and of course they put up lots and lots of beaver board. Now, beaver board is the boards that they kind of use. We would kind of consider it kind of like our drywall a little bit, but it's the boards that they put up on the inside of their house, on their ceilings, and on the insides that kind of protect it, protect it. And so knowing that this is not the first time we've used beaver board, I always find it fascinating that the people in Belize think that we can hammer nails, and we can't hammer nails. So we just can't. The group cannot hammer nails. No, but no group has really ever been able to. I know Jared's probably back in the sound booth right now going, oh, just shaking his head. But we do screws a lot better. And so that's kind of how we improvised and did that, because screwing things onto a ceiling with nailing is extremely hard when you bend like every 7 nails. So, and then before you get one to stick. So, but that group did a great job. And one of the things that they did was they built a good relationship with Martha. Martha's a lady that's involved in their church. It's important that you realize that she had no electricity. In order to get electricity, they had to run a large extension cord from her father's house. That's not too far away, or pretty far away. I'm not really sure. I didn't see how far it was. It's just a long extension cord. And so that's how she had it. And she also has no indoor plumbing. And so they have a toilet. And so how they go to the bathroom is when the toilet, it empties into a bucket, and then they clean the bucket out or dump the bucket and dump the waste. And so you have to understand that she was pretty primitive in some of her things. But with that said, her house was one of a newer construction, and it just didn't have anything done really on the inside. And so our group went in and helped a lot on the inside and helped get things together. One of the things that's really challenging when you're working in Belize is a lot of times the inside of the house is full of their things. And so it really makes things extremely tight and hard at sometimes to find enough room for everybody to be involved and everybody to be involved at certain things. And so that always provides one of the challenges for the group is how to get along, how to work together, and how to, you know, accomplish some of their things in which they are. That's a group of them putting it up in the ceiling, working together. That's part of the group in front of the house. Work project two. We had an opportunity. This wasn't on our list to begin with to start the week, but there is a ministry called Belize Camping Ministry, and Heather and Heather and Chris, they were able to go and spend a couple days at this ministry, and one of the things in which they did there was they varnished a table, and I think it was built out as an old bowling alley, if I remember correctly, and they kind of varnished it to make it into a very nice table. But it was an awesome opportunity for them, and that's a picture with them and the family, Alex and Leah, I believe, and that's them with the family that's kind of doing this ministry. But it was just kind of an awesome opportunity for them and for part of our group to be involved in something that's a little bit bigger in Belize that's already established and be involved and be a blessing to them. Work project three, I was part of this work project mostly. This was done for a guy in the Belize church that we partner with, Open Door Church. And he was he's involved in Open Door. He's a sound guy at Open Door. But during COVID, he had some complications from diabetes. He lost part of his leg and became mostly blind in his eyes. Luckily, he just, I guess, had a surgery, he was telling us, in Guatemala, and he's hopeful that some of his sight will be able to return, but he says it's really, really cloudy, and it's really, really a struggle. But so it was an awesome opportunity for us to go and be a blessing to him him and his sister who live at this house. Some of the different things in which we did here was we ripped off all the outside exterior walls and put new ones on. We painted. We did a lot of trim work. We put new windows in. We built new stairs. We broke pipes that we had to replace, apparently. That water was flying over everywhere. I kept hearing that over and over again, but I don't know. You'll have to talk to the Belize members on that one. So we also did some things inside. The hardest part about a project like this in Belize, for us as Americans, is we want to make things perfect. We want things to be perfect. And the hardest thing to kind of understand and do is realize that we'll never, ever be able to make perfect. We're only there a week, and that we can't do every single thing that needs to be done. However, we can focus on percentages over perfection. And that was kind of the message in which we kind of talked about over and over again through the week. Because it is frustrating, because you're like, if I had my tools at home, you know, we'd be able to knock this out really quick. And that's not how things really work there. And that's part of the challenge and part of the growth that takes place with the people that go on Belize. But percentages over perfection. And so some of the things we can do, you can see here's a before picture, there's an after picture, that's the same. So you can see it's really easy sometimes to see kind of the extreme home makeover things that you can do there of the different things we did. We replaced the roof while we were there. And we also worked a lot with, the kids would walk by of the house and they would be excited to see us and built a nice relationship with them as we would go. We also, because you saw in the video, we did some free time. One of the coolest things we get to do is swim in the ocean, and we get to snorkel, and we get to, and you saw some of the video of how clear the water was and swimming with sharks and stingrays and stuff like that. So we spent an afternoon a day in Key Cocker, which is one of the keys in Belize, and we did that. So what we're going to do now, so I'm going to end with one little thing, and then what you're going to do is you're going to talk at your group. Wednesday, we showed up to church. And we hadn't been there for several years, 5 years or so. And what was awesome to me, what was the impactful to me, was looking around the church and seeing the different families that we've impacted since 2009 when we started going. Just seeing the different families. And one of the families came up to me, and she's like, "Hey, you probably don't remember me," which was not true. I did remember her. She goes, "But you helped me with one of my projects when, you know, you were one of the first projects or your team did." And of course I remembered. Her name was Carol Jenkins. And I remember her project because it started our trips in Belize. But just to look around the church and know that there are tons and tons of families that need help, that tons and tons of family that we can provide a little bit of relief to. But knowing that the relationship and knowing that there is still something there, a connection there from all the years previous, from 15 years ago, that is still there and still a part of it, is what was impactful and important to me. Because I remembered back to that time. Her husband just recently, like 6 weeks before we went to Belize, died. And she was a single mom with multiple kids. And what she needed most was her washer to be moved into her bathroom and kind of fixed into the plumbing. She needed bunk beds so her kids would have a place to sleep, and she needed parts of her kitchen just to be remodeled. Of course, I remember working and helping and being a part of those. But to know that we still meant something to her and she sought us out after church just to, again, say thank you, you know, 14, 15 years after the fact is important. Because, listen, paint's going to fade. Wood's going to rot. Things are going to go south because that's just the natural order of things. But relationships and making a difference and showing love to others, that makes a lot lasting impact. That lasts a lot longer than the projects that we're ever going to do and the pictures that you're going to see here today. So what I want you to do is I want to make sure there's a Belize person kind of at each table. We have 12 Belize people here today. So make sure there's a Belize person in each table. And I'm going to give you about 10 minutes or so. You can talk through these questions. I know that for some of the students, it may be easier if you interview them a little bit. Maybe you ask them the question. That might help get them talking a little bit. Feel free to go off script. Ask any questions that you have with the people from Belize. And in about 10 minutes, I'll come up, and then I'll have the people in Belize switch spots. Is there any table that doesn't have a Belize person so I can make sure I get one there? I don't see one there. Right? Is there a Belize person at your table I can't see? No. We need to get one. Oh, yes, Heather is. Sorry, Heather. Anyway, get started.